Welcome to your doom. Shut it and get up here. Massive uppercuts!
Hello and welcome to another edition of the JabJab Show. Today I'm on the floor. This could only mean one thing. Yes, I'm reviewing a video game. Today's video game is concerning my Amstrad-A-Thon. This is part two of it. I did a video a short while back, an unboxing of a lot of Amstrad games for Amstrad Action cover tapes. You know, they got with the Amstrad Action magazines from back in the day. Now, this is part two of it, and today it is a game, Ranarama. There you go, that big froggy up there. I go with it. Okay, this is from Amstrad Action, Action Pack 13, Tape 13, April 1992, so, you know, that's when I released this. My cousins had the game for the Spectrum back down south. I've seen it in action and whatever when they were playing it and so on. I've not really played that much myself. I made a few notes. Let's see. Okay, this was 1987 came out, developed by Graftgold, published by Hewson Consultants. Now, they're the same people who developed Southern Bell, a game which I made a video a while back about. For the Spectrum, that game came out for the all the other computers and so on. But I made it for the Southern Bell. I didn't really do that well with that game. You can check it out in my playlist if you want to. Hewson Consultants, very diverse, very prolific. Developers from back in the day. So, like I say, on a lot of my video game things and what have you, I'm not scared of playing games that I've not played a lot before and so on. I just do, to do these videos for you and so on. So, without further ado, let's play the game. Alright, so we met with the Amstrad homepage, if you will. Just to let you know, I've had to go loading this and it's just stayed on the blue screen saying loading. And it went through pretty much the whole tape and I got to a point where should have come, loaded up like already and it just stayed on the blue screen saying loading. Which isn't a good sign. Anyway, we'll have another go. So press control and little enter. Where are you, little enter? There you are. Let's press play and press any key. The key I pressed was K. Anyway, if you are there, you're wondering. So it's gonna load. All going well. Now, I had an issue with Spin Dizzy, my previous video. That wasn't working. Loading many block one, which is a good sign. And I ended up doing the going through the emulator route with that game. I don't want to go through the emulator route with this one. I want it to work properly. But anyway, we'll see. So I did a bit of research on this game. Let's say I'm aware of it previously, but basically, Graftgold. It's a game developer from 1983 to 1998. Spans tons of systems, including Dragon 32, Commodore 64, Spectrum, Amstrad, all the way up to the PlayStation. Okay. Press the spacebar to select program. Let's press return key. Ah, do I have to press? No? Okay. Okay, it's doing it wrong. Then we need Ranarama. Let's press the return key. There we go. And there's the loading screen it stayed on last time. Anyhow, so what I'm saying is about Graftgold. Yeah, all the way up to the PlayStation. There's lots of games, lots and lots of games. I'm not going to list them all now. The last game they did that I found was Rainbow Islands for the PC and PlayStation back in 1996. Ranarama is a top-down action game style in the style of Gauntlet. One of my favourite games, that is. Love this stuff, call it. You play as Mervyn, he's a sorcerer's apprentice, and he turned himself into a frog. He escapes an invasion of a bunch of evil magic users, who kills his mentors. Mervyn has to track them down and learn them. Learn them a lesson. Oh! Right. That didn't happen last time. Sorry about this, folks. This is all live, like a Saturday morning TV show. I'm not sure, do they have, I'm guessing they still have Saturday morning shows like Going Live and Live and Kicking and whatever else they were, can't we? And number 73, I vaguely remember that. Anyway, let's have another go. I don't know what button I pressed then, I've just pressed any key. I didn't find out. So like I say, I might be able to fathom it, this whole magic system and other stuff, like, as I'm playing it. But we'll see if the bloody thing works. This is attempt number 4 of this. So I found block 1, found block 2 last time, which is pretty good. We'll see what happens. So I want to play as a frog, and I want to play it on the actual Amstrad if I can, if that's not too much to ask. I don't know how long it's going to take to load, if it does load. So unfortunately I don't think it's working. I don't feel it's working. It's gone through a lot of loading noises and what have you. And you know, if you're off all with the Spectrum and Amstrad and the Commodore, their noises of making, you know, when they do load, this sounds like another game loading up basically. So I'm not going to spend all day. I ain't got all night to do this. So unfortunately, I'm going to have to, you know, admit defeat with this one, and play this on an emulator in ROM. So next thing you'll see is my laptop all set up and while we're doing all the stuff. So because basically I press stop and it stopped, and apparently it's still loading, but we can't be, can't stop the blooming tape. Anyway, so I'd say next thing you'll see is a laptop with it all loaded up. See you later. Okay, so here we go. This is my laptop with the emulator I'm using for this one, WinApe. I don't know if it'll win an ape if I use this. But either way, there's a lot of emulators available, so I'll sort of panic here. What's going on here? Right, anyway. There's WinApe. Question, has anyone won an ape at any point? What did you do to win an ape? Let me know down below in the comment section. Anyhow, let's see, let's maximise. You can see all the things there, my mouse is gone. All I do is do that. It's all hilarious. I'm looking at this at an angle, so I can't quite. Alright, it's a disk image, because it's DSK image, which is Ranarama, as you can see. So it's doing stuff. Now this might be a bit too loud, this, because I think it has. Does that mean infinite lives? It's kind of an anagram, but without the L. Oh, you can have a normal party. I don't know. I might have to turn the volume down on this. I don't know. Has he done it? Yeah, I think we need to. Okay, that's more manageable, I think. Okay, so I'm going to use the joystick on this, as in the controller I've got. Might be a bit easier. I don't know if you can hear me over the hilarious music. And oh, no, there we go. Let's turn it down a little bit more, in case there's in-game music. Okay, a little bit more. You still should be able to hear it. Okay, I can always toggle that as and when. So, I did test this on the emulator. Obviously, it does work, as you can see. It does have an option of joystick or keyboards. The keyboards favour the right-handed player, which I am not one of, so it's going to be, I found it a little difficult to do, but let's see. Okay, so I've got my notes here. I need to, basically, to play Ranarama. This is taken from, so you got print out of the instructions off the internet. Aim of the game is to start on the top level of the dungeon and defeat each warlock that you encounter. Don't get sidetracked, the warlocks are key to the game. Seek them out, destroy those around them, then jump on them. Because remember, you're a frog in this one, so frogs obviously jump. Incidentally, on the way home tonight, I saw a frog. There we go. So, let's see. I'm a froggy. And there's a thing there. Oh, okay. I've done stuff. All that means. But I'm a foggy and I navigate various levels. As you can see. Let's fire him. Okay. I don't know. Cast of Stones, I am doing. I'm panicking, I don't know. Okay. Did I win? I don't know if I won. But I did something or other then. It does mention of the doing stuff to spell the word Ranarama. But it's kind of bewildering that bit then. Look at these little spiders there, let's get them. Right, I'm getting leathered here. Stuff is getting me. Right, okay. Well, I can see, that's made in 1988. I can see the gauntlet kind of inspiration going on. Because you got generators, and you got all these little things. The things that I'm shooting, I'm seeing bullets there, they're not really doing much, there's no real... Right, I need to kill these generators. Just like in Gauntlet, you kill the generators and there's no, like, generating monsters coming out. There we go. Right, so... Let's just go around getting stuff. Oh, done stuff. What was that? Was that a bomb? What are you doing? Right, what are the other functions there? Obviously. Ah! Someone got me. Got me! My score was that. As you can see, there's another one of them. So I'm pretty far behind of what I need to do. Okay. Okay. Sell out fire, da 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 da. Pause the game. Okay, right, I can pause the game. There you go. Dee 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 dee. What the hell? Which one am I? There I am. Right, okay. What do I do in this bit here? I don't know what I'm doing. Glyph. I don't know what glyph is. I'm here now. How have I got here? There you go, I'll learn them. So, I'm here now. There you go. Okay, that's a little map thing. Let's get all this triangle up. Okay, I don't know. Okay, I've got that stuff. I don't know. Okay, let's go down there and see what happens. Oh, someone getting me. Can I get these? Are these generators? Are these blue things here? Ah, where are they coming from? I should be able to just get them. Ah, okay, I see. I think I know what I'm on about now. Now, these triangle ones actually are a thing that tells you what you've got. In terms of magic and whatever, and this is a map, so I'm there, as you can see. Okay, and now, okay, I can't even now it's here. So I'm Mervyn the frog, am I? Mervyn? I don't know. I'm getting leathered here. I can't afford to keep looking at the instructions. Okay, someone's beach ball's getting me. I thought, oh, there we are, the dude get destroyed. I see. Pew, pew, pew. Got me. Right, God, that's how long we go. It's a random generated where you start and stuff. Right, okay, let's go on here. Okay, so that's that. Whatever that is, well, that's one of them. Okay, Foggy Foggy. He's not... Alright. Oh, there you go, so I win. Lovely stuff. What did I get then? I got an eye. I'm there. Okay. I think, therefore I am. Okay. Anyway, let's get all this. I am intrigued with this game. It seems to be... I'm learning stuff as I go. I'm not sure... Can I use them spells? I don't want to be like, oh, something's happening. I don't want to be like, you know, go for it, like looking at the instruction books all the time. I don't like them kind of games where you're required to read all the manual several times and study it just to play a game. It's just not what I'm into. But this one seems to be like, you know, quite intuitive. Now, I get the basic of it, you gotta kill all these little things, you get the generators. Like him, that guy there. How many shots does he take? There you go, about six or something. So I just need to navigate stuff. Kill the generators and kill all the things. Collect stuff and go down to the dungeon below. That's all I need to know. And there's some magic along the way. But I'm not fussed about that, to be honest, at the moment. Alright, so if I press pause... Alright, sort of got me. Alright, oh, why did... I don't know. Alright, where's my power? Where's my energy and stuff? Is it, like, constantly depleting because of, like gauntlet? Let's have a go. Let's beat this guy up here. Lovely. Right, these are all gone. Let's have a look at the map. There I am. Okay. Do I need to get there? Okay, interesting. Oh, Foggy. Right. Oh, there we go. I'm pressing stuff. Let's... Okay. Alright, let's go down there. What are you doing? Oh, what's happening? I'm in here now. Little spider things. It looks pretty much... This game does look like a Spectrum game, obviously, with a few flourishes here and there for the Amstrad. But this could easily, graphically and stuff, it could easily be the Spectrum version of... I'm getting to know more about the Amstrad and what have you. Like I've said in lots of videos, because he used to have one, he's been playing it, and he had this game, I think. No, the cousins now staff had this for the Spectrum, but I've never played it. Right. Why am I going a different way to what I'm pointing? Have I got some kind of... What are you doing? It's kind of a bit weird, the controls. Let's go this way. I don't know. It's full of things, so no. Oh, something happened. See this spider, it reminded me of a spider you see in Hewson and the Spiders, if you ever played that on a Spectrum. Oh, I'm getting leathered here. Right, let's press pause. Okay, it didn't come up with the screen, okay. Right, so, if I press fire again, it should unpause. Right, let's see what that is. There we go. Leathers everyone in the room, which is pretty cool. Right, come on. Why is the controls gone weird now? I want to... Right, what? Seriously, what's happening now? There we go. Alright. Am I nearly energy depleted and all that? Oh, what are you doing? Yeah, I thought so. Look at that though. You know, my score is, whoever that guy is, 20,000 quid. Alright, let's have a further look at it. Bugger it. It's enjoyable. I'll just be bewildered by how the whole magic thing works. I get the whole map and the inventory that you can pull up and whatever, and the killing of the various crazy creatures and the generators and stuff. Come on. Right. Okay. What? That's not right, is it? Right. Okay, I get it. I think I get it. You have to spell Ranarama. Okay. It's telling me stuff. Right. Foggy. Right. Let's go on the eye. The all-seeing eye. I am where? I'm aware that where that white block is, aren't I? Let's blow stuff up. There you go, I'll learn them. Ain't no one there though. Right. Yellow light. There you go. So if, as long as the game's like, you know, kind of keep simple in there. Things in their like ways of playing. There we go. Come on. All these noises. Yay, I win. I know what I'm doing on that bit now. There we go. I collect these little things here. What do they, I don't know what they do. I'm about to expire, I think. I need to get to that. Oh, I learned them. Right, one more go. It does have the extra go factor, this one. Cause it feels fun. And it is possibly one of the good game, great games on the Amstrad. Oh, just in general, I mean, I don't know. What are you doing? Why is he turning around when I'm not even turning? That's weird. Right, am I stuck now? What do we do here? Seriously, how do I get out of this bit here? There's not much to see these little bits, this is where you know you can get in. Am I stuck here? What's going on? Why is it? Is this like some kind of, I found a bug in the game where if you do a certain thing, you just, oh, there we are. That was a bit weird, like I had to leave that. Alright, what was that though? Okay, I'm there. Let's go up here. I don't know. Right, you. I'll learn ya. Right, let's go this way. Oh, bugger. Is it quicker just to dodge these three things? Shit, hundreds of them now. Why is it all slowing down now? Like it's some kind of like action film that's about to blow up or something. Ah, why is hundreds of them? Go away. Right, there we go. What's the point in having out there when there's nothing there? The screen before had tons of stuff. Let's leg it. Where are we going? Ah! What's happened? What happened then? Something happened. Right, where am I? Where am I? Oh, the wrong thing. It's the eye, which makes sense. Right, I'm there. I'm guessing that's me. So, I don't know what they're supposed to be. There's that just there to, look, I'm pressing down on the controller. And, yeah, it's not quite working. Anyway. I'm getting a numb ass doing this. Ow. Right, where am I? There I am. Oh, there's a thing there. I've not seen that one before. Let's see what that does. So you go on it and you press fire. And that is that. Okay. Okay. Is there a game called Pajama-rama? Because I thought my cousins might have had a game called something like Pajama-rama on a Spectrum, which is more of a surreal platform, well, much in the same way as like Jet Set Willy or Manic Miner. I'm sure they had this, but now I'm thinking there was something else, Arama kind of game. Drain minimum, what does that mean? Ah, what's going on? Now, where am I? There I am. Leg it, spider things are getting you. Right. Oh, there we go, let's go through here. I think it's gonna get me. This will be better with. Ow! I'm sat in a really awkward place in order to play this. Alright. No, that's me gone. 8,200, right, I'll have one more go. No, even. Ow! But it's really awkward to play this. I've sat down. Playing it up, no, it's just hurting me bum. Anyway, let's do that. Nothing there to kill, but there we go. Oh, there we go, let's kill him. There we go, I'll learn him. Foggy. There we go, am I in shot there? I'm leaning forward, just seeing if I can get a comfier way to sit. Right, I'll bugger, let's get that. Okay, come on. Nope. Bugger, I'm too round. No, now mortal. I thought I was mortal anyway. Getting leathered off all the little spiders and that. Anyway, what's going on? Where am I? Pyam. Yeah, this would be good with the gauntlet speech. Spinny thing. We'll take seven. Well, actually, thinking about it, when you first encounter a ghost, for example, and you went into it, it just went do 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 do, with text saying ghosts will take 7 bits of health off you. I think it was 7. But anyway, you get the idea. It'd be good to go on that speech. Frog now has extra visibility, invisibility even, because extra visibility. I don't know how that'd work. It wouldn't work for you, would it? I wasn't able to see you more. Anyway. Just overthinking these things. I don't know. There we go. Alright, I think it's just easier just to get away from them. Because all these things take about 5 hits and that. It's just now half an hour just getting rid of them. There you go. Ah, no, I've got no chance. No, that spider's like metal or something, it takes ages. Ah, so there we go. That's my end result, but I did get more points on some of the other games. So that was Ranarama for the Amstrad CPC 464, via, once again, an emulator ROM, because the tape didn't work properly, as you saw. It's just, I'm not going to ask the guy that I bought it from my money back. These shapes are 20 odd years old, these 25, 26 years old, they're probably not going to be perfect, are they? Over time, I don't know how they were stored, they were just in a loft, Magnetic tape does erode and does deteriorate over time, as I don't know, with the VHS tapes, that's similar kind of magnetic tape kind of technology. Anyhow, so Ranarama, yeah, so it's good, don't get me wrong. I've not played it too much, to be honest. I think I've got my wires crossed with what my cousin had when thinking about it during the gameplay moment. I thought, Was there a pajama arm or something for the Spectrum, which I was thinking, right, I must have misheard or misread it as a kid. But Ranarama, pajama arm, I don't know, because I remember him playing a platformer called Pajama Rama. He was kidding, pajamas. It's all very sketchy in my head, I don't know. Anyway, but what we do have, Ranarama, it's again, like Spin Dizzy, it's quite pick up and play. There's things about, like I said in, I think, part one of the of this video, where I say there's some stuff involving magic and spells and runes and things, which I suppose as I get to play it and so on even more, I would understand it, but I'll understand that side a bit more. This is, you know, quite a simple enough game. I can see where the inspiration from Gauntlet has come from, obviously the top down perspective and the generators and so on. You know, I appreciate all that, and obviously, you know, it's kind of bizarre being a frog. I mean, no one tell me. But, you know, if you complete the game, does he turn back to the sorcerer? You know, perhaps, don't spoil it for me, because, you know, this is another game like Spin Dizzy. I can see myself playing for a lot longer, you know, like, obviously got to consider the length of this video and so on. So, I don't want to be, dying and getting beaten up and things, getting it wrong for hours and hours. People are going to get bored with, well, people who are Ranarama experts, thinking, This guy don't know what he's doing. I can, you know, just watch this. I'll show you how to do it and so on. But I'm waffling on. So yeah, the graphics sound, they're okay. They're okay, not great. Like I said in the gameplay bit, you know, the Spectrum version, the Amstrad, sorry, it looks still like a Spectrum game, to be honest. It doesn't really utilise the relative colour, like improved colour palette the Amstrad has, and the kind of distinct graphics. It does a little bit, but you know, the graphics aren't great. The music, you know, obviously that's turned down a bit because it's just a bit sort of garish. It's a bit, I don't know. It's okay. It's fun. It's good that has music here and there, but you know, it's not something I can listen to for much longer than it's on. What are your memories of this game for the Amstrad? Are the ports available? It is available, as I said, on the Spectrum and also on the Commodore 64. So what are your memories of these games? What's your favourite port if you played them all, or played like a couple of them or whatever? Just let me know down below in the comment section. And also, who's your favourite frog in retro games? You know, there's a few of them here and there that I can think of right now. Just let me know down below what's your favourite frog in video games. Like, subscribe, comment, all the rest of it, and tell your friends and everything. And in the words of the new Cyrus, send the word. 9, 8, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7, 7,